What's up, guys? It is Taylor here and Mason Lloyd from TMT Games.
TMT Games, guys.
And we're reacting to the top 10 scariest games of the last decade.
Technically, by recording, I'm reacting.
That is correct. So, guys, we're wearing the same clothing. Please bear with us. We've recorded a few videos today. Once again,
that's a good shout.
We are still intoxicated, guys, so please bear with us.
In this video, more intoxicated than the last videos.
You see,
this is all a progression.
We just keep getting more and more intoxicated, guys.
Yeah, we're just filming a few videos tonight.
Indeed.
Having a few beers.
Indeed.
Enjoying the night, and we're going to do some cool reaction videos. So this video is going to be the WatchMojos top 10 scariest games of the last decade.
That's it,
guys. If you do enjoy these kind of videos, drop a like, subscribe if you haven't already. If you enjoy the face cam, let me know down below, because this guy enjoys the face cam.
I do indeed, guys. This is
let's just jump straight into the reaction, guys. Top 10 scariest games of the last decade. Let's go.
This is some 11-minute action.
11 minutes.
Nothing like a little fear to get the heart.
This is Ricky Tucci speaking. Respect, Ricky Tucci.
And today he's got a cool haircut.
He's got a cool voice. Games of the last not like the last
decade.
Guy.
What's that, Rez?
This list that's definitely Rez.
So, yeah.
Scariest video games released throughout the 2010s and ranking them based on scare
factor, legacy,
and
overall influence
on
the whole. This guy's playing this right now. You should definitely check it out.
Guys, definitely. Well, I hope there's no spoilers for me.
Well, I hope not. Well, you made it to come out. Is it? If it comes out,
definitely.
Alan Wake.
Number 10.
Never played this game, but I haven't heard of it.
If like Stephen King and Stephen King merged together, then Alan Wake would be the result. It tells the story of the titular Alan Wake, a novelist who tries to uncover
that's a typical story. The wife disappears. Pretty similar,
right?
Of course, the town's name is largely
ironic. Then the husband goes and hunts for the wife, comes across some creepy ass fucking people, and then
is the actor what's his name? Speed, super strength. He looks a lot like what's his face, the famous actor. He's a serious actor. He broke his ankle doing his own stunt.
Tom Cruise.
He looks like Tom Cruise.
Tom Cruise in a video game that we respect.
It's not bloody or gory or visually impacting, but there's just something really creepy about being hunted and stalked by the darkness itself. Not to mention it has the ability to turn the town's inhabitants
into looks quite familiar.
Nothing
kind of gameplay.
Or more powerless.
Them guys don't really scare me. They're too scary.
Yeah,
they just don't
know.
Wow. Dead Space 2. Now let's trip me out,
Dead
guys.
Space 2.
I'm glad this is on.
It's scary. I've never played
these monsters used to fucking trip me out. They used to jump out of the fucking vents and everything.
How old were you when you played this?
When it first came out on PlayStation 3.
Now if you
want
to talk viscerally impacting, let's talk about Dead Space 2.
So like probably...
The Dead Space series was the medium's answer to the scary
wow, that was
like 10 years ago.
Space inherently...
Shit, Dead Space
2. About 13.
Seemingly beyond human these games are sick, man. I hope they could bring out the next one out for next gen.
Short,
these games
really
are so amazing.
Imagination
or horror though. Game.
And not in a fun way.
What, is it set in space?
Yeah. These monsters would trip me out.
When they were 13.
Like you had to shoot the limbs off. And there was like big giant bosses and all that,
and some truly disturbing body
I've
horror.
I've played Dead Space, like, I must say.
That is Dead Space 2. We didn't think it could get much scarier
but
than
Dead Space 2
game.
Was probably the best
this
of the bunch,
us
so I can see why they put this in there. It
looks intense, though. You should remaster this shit.
Right. I mean, like a prequel. Dead Space 3 was a prequel as well. I'm not sure.
Layers of Fear?
Number 16. Layers of Fear.
Never heard of this either.
Spazbo
4. 636.
Developed by the oddly named
369.
Layers of Fear is a psychological horror that takes its cues and influences from the independent horror titles of the early decade.
More
on
that
later.
Intense.
You play as a mentally disturbed artist who is trying to paint his masterpiece, but who keeps getting distracted by puzzles and an ever-changing mansion.
Oh, that is trippy.
Yeah. These kind of games trip me out when you like with like first person like similar res.
Like most psychological games,
man.
Layers of Fear places the camera
super close. You like
you
feel like you're in the game.
What is
definitely.
And isn't
wow.
real. As such, it asks us to share in the protagonist's
well,
surreal experience, even if
whoa,
that's
a lot of fucking chess pieces. Like check out pieces for the
indeed.
Board.
Persistent jump scares and disturbing visions definitely don't help.
Oh, door on the floor.
That's some good artwork, though, guys.
Yeah, it's a cool design. Wow, you fell for it.
Until Dawn.
Wow,
we've seen Until Dawn.
This game.
Until Dawn.
I played this game. This is a pretty cool game.
How's this happening?
Well, it's fucking a. That's a famous actor right there.
It is, isn't it?
Until Dawn is one of the PlayStation 4's
and it's got fucking what's it called? Rami Malek.
Adventure style of game.
Night in the Museum.
The Pharaoh guy.
And characters. And he's Freddie Mercury. Influenced
from a wide variety of horror styles, starting as a creepy slasher in the vein of Friday the 13th.
It's a good game. Super cool story. Tale involving your decisions, like, not change the game or not. It was free as well, guys. That was pretty cool. I got it for free.
I watched this on YouTube. Dashy Games. Stories.
But the stress of keeping your characters alive and trying to make the best decisions possible also adds an element of unpredictability that helps keep the game fresh and relentlessly nerve-wracking. If
you're faking it, oh, that's a specky guy right
there. Wow, the Evil Within.
Is this the Evil Within? This is the first one, though. This was tripped me out as well.
Fuck, he looks like the Executioner from Resident Evil.
In my opinion, the first one was scarier than the second one. The second one was more action.
Total horror. Looks scary, like, yeah.
The Evil Within was bound to be compared to the Resident Evil series. But while the latter primarily focuses on B-movie thrills like zombies, mutants, and parasites, The Evil Within is
like them. That woman creeped me out with the fucking arms and that.
Wow.
Oh. Jesus, God.
Its themes were more in line with Silent Hill than Resident Evil.
Sebastian, something nothing US called.
Otherworldly locations, a general nightmarish tone, and a story so bizarre and bonkers.
Wow, that's a good tune. Bonkers,
Did you have to rest?
And who can forget the grotesque and and everyone's favorite, The Keeper. It's deeply disturbing, but also incredibly rewarding.
Oh, this is definitely some classic graphics, though.
Well, I hope there's no fucking
Resident Evil 7.
Spoilers, no, guys.
We have to take
the head. Yeah, guys, I'm going to take the head. Oh, yeah. I'm not listening, guys.
A lot was riding on Resident Evil
5. Resident Evil 5, oh, there
Resident Evil 5 was considered a bit of a disappointment.
But it's still going to be, still on Resident 7.
And 6 was,
so just be careful.
Well, let's not talk about 6. Now taking cues from the Texas Chainsaw Massacre,
guys, because I'm doing this playthrough currently, I'm just going to not react to this. Mason, I can react to it.
Yeah, you're going to do this to it.
From the unnerving atmosphere of the family residents, alongside disturbing boss battles and
this is where I am right now. I want these bitch asses right now.
Both psychological and visceral. There may not have been a familiar face in sight from the very end, but
Don't look.
No spoilers.
The franchise back from the brink.
I'll tell you what it's done, bro.
Resident Evil 2.
This guy is paying for this game now. He'll respect that shit. Done.
Number 4. Alien Isolation.
Jesus Christ.
Alien Isolation, I've seen this on YouTube. Oh shit! Guys, sorry.
We did it. We got an alien game in keeping with the first movie's tone. Most Alien titles have followed in the bombast of James Cameron's Aliens, and that's fine. But a lot of the franchise's fans were
clearly... I finished this game, guys. I've caught this game. And honestly,
did you play this?
Yeah, I finished it.
I had no idea.
Creative assembly
cool game. Super cool game. Really intense. But super fun. The atmosphere, like, super atmospheric. Really cool game.
There are few video games as stressful the alien and anxiety
all over the place,
as
right?
This,
yeah.
As you are persistently hunted by the titular alien.
And literally, the whole game is hunted by the alien. And there's like some androids and stuff, but basically,
but most of the aliens spent cowering under tables or holding your breath in a locker as the alien stomps and sniffs.
Wow, shit! We need to fucking play some of these games on the channel.
So
fast. Some scary.
You've got a good start in Resident Evil 7.
Guys, if you do enjoy the fucking horror games, the scary-ass games, drop a comment down below and let us know, alright, guys?
Wow.
It's PT, cancelled. What the deuce? It's a fucking baby in the sink.
Is that you? It's a fucking fetus?
If you've been living under a rock
PT.
For the last
you think Red Dead again, right?
A playable teaser, hence the
Red Dead.
For a new Silent Hill.
Resident Evil, shit.
This guy says Red Dead all the time.
You know what I mean?
Was it being directed by
it's from Hideo Kojima.
Del Toro, but the demo alone was scarier and more impactful than a lot of AAA
games. That's a guy who did
this demo was a masterclass in horror, creating tension like anything else and cycling through a wide variety of horror styles, each of which were
Amazon fucking delivery game. Seriously
terrifying. The Amazon delivery game.
It's a masterpiece of supernatural horror, and it will never
elaborate.
See the light
of day. You know, with the delivery guy, where you're like, wow, how you gonna die for that game? Was it called again?
Number 2, you're gonna... Outlast.
Hold on. Bro, elaborate. What game is this?
It's
Fuck. What were we talking about specifically? Because we've got alcohol on the go.
I don't know the name. You know, the guy from The Walking Dead, Norman Reedus. He's the main character.
Yes. We weren't talking about it earlier.
The Amazon game, where you're like the delivery guy, where you're like, oh,
I know what you're talking about.
That's a game called? What the deuce?
It's Death Stranding.
Death Stranding, like, that's a game on it, guys. That's a game on it.
That's what he's talking about.
Same guy from Death Stranding.
Are you ready? Let's
yeah,
go.
Let's go.
What's this, Outlast? Oh, this looks scary. I've watched this shit on YouTube.
Outlast
yeah,
helped
wow.
Define the independent
this guy should play this shit.
Oh, bro, don't get me started on this. Resident Evil is enough.
To a seemingly abandoned insane asylum to uncover the truth about.
Well, I'm trying to have a guess at number. What could be number one? Like, what's for?
These dudes are scary.
The gameplay is relatively simplistic, as it mostly consists of walking around, running away from enemies, and hiding under beds. Most of
this
the game's mastery lies
I couldn't finish
it,
right?
Guys. I played it,
but our intrinsic fear of the dark. Of being chased
you don't finish it.
And of being helpless against an enemy.
Why? Because you were scared, or just because it was too
it's
hard?
Amazing what Red Barrels managed to do.
Not scared, just
gameplay,
yeah.
And it helped
all the timing and
the
like,
games were made
I got stuck.
Decade.
And it's one of them games where it's like it's all about you know hiding and maneuvering. You can't right. Fight back, and it get old for the whole game.
Our most horrifying.
Oh, Freddy! Yeah, Freddy! Fucking
honorable mentions.
Freddy's Nights or something.
Five Nights at Freddy's.
Yeah, yeah, that's the same. Yeah, it's the same player. But this must be a different game. This is meant to be pretty trippy.
Yeah, I've seen this game. Whoa,
this game's meant to be trippy as well.
Insane.
It's got meant to be like a meant to have some like random creatures and stuff.
Oh,
Slender,
so
of course. We love Slender. What's gonna be number one? This game's gonna be pretty sick as well. But I've never played it.
So
no, I've never heard of this. This is underwater, because underwater trips me out.
Wow, yeah.
It looks like it's underwater to me.
Yeah, it definitely
before
does.
We continue, be
South
sure
wow,
Southpaw?
Wait, that was number one.
You have the option to be notified for occasional videos, or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure to go into your settings and switch on notifications.
Okay.
Number one, Amnesia.
Amnesia?
The
Amnesia the Dark Descent.
I've never heard of it.
See him. If it's number one, though.
Yeah, it must be pretty trippy.
The legacy of Amnesia cannot be overstated. It kickstarted the independent horror craze of the early 2010s, and its gameplay mechanics and general style were heavily copied throughout the decade. The game has you control a man named Daniel as he explores a dark and foreboding castle, solves intricate puzzles, and nightmarish creatures that literally cause him to go insane.
So was this like you said, was this like an influence on like
horror
games.
Games?
Yeah.
Never before
was this the first of like this kind of you know first person searching survival kind of horror game?
Vulnerable.
You oh, we'll have to play this, bro.
Looks
by
pretty
the time
intense.
Credits roll, never
if,
mind
it's, if it's number one, it's got to be
a
know.
Masterful example of the survival
indeed.
Horror genre, and it remains
it?
One of the
survival horror
games
yeah.
Ever made.
Ever made? Wow, that's a big praise. I haven't showed much scary stuff, but
yeah.
If it's number one, you know.
They haven't showed
in
much
I believe.
Awesome gaming
wow,
wow, Doug Judy, the Pontiac Bandits, guys. Brooklyn 99, watch it if you haven't already.
Well, is that the end of the video, guys? I think that's the end of the video, guys. So
I hope you enjoyed it, guys, though.
Yeah,
I hope
we enjoyed
you enjoyed
the video. If you do like these kind of videos, you know, smash the like button, subscribe if you haven't already. And, yeah, guys, have a good day.
And hope you enjoyed the video.